parliament is given enormous powers, no? What happens that we had a meeting with the president and he asked the parties to be more active, to play a very important role into society. He requested the parliament to exercise more parliamentary control and scrutiny, and at the same time to work hand by hand with the government in order to help him. We see reform of judiciary system. We never had infinite term for judges. Now we have 5 years, 10 years, and then infinite term. So they are becoming more and more independent. We see sort of awakening of the media. And now if you read our news, if you go to Facebook, Twitter, or whatever, you see how people are openly discussing things that they've never been discussing before. And they're criticizing, in many cases, government. So those processes are happening, and that empowers, say, all the instruments of making sure that the process of reform will go on and will continue. So it is not only words, it is also deeds, and we perfectly understand that there are challenges ahead of us, but we also understand that these challenges must neither be underestimated but not allowed to overwhelm the anyone. What was one of the major obstacles for development of Uzbekistan to become more business friendly was the issue of cross-liberalization of the trade regime, liberalization of the investment regime, and of course the way how we work with foreign companies, and so-called notorious convertibility issue, and the foreign companies could not transfer their earnings in hard currency back to their countries. So that issue was totally resolved. So any company can freely go to Uzbekistan, sell their goods, products, services, get their money immediately in hard currency and transfer it without any handicaps, problems, and issues. And that means that our doors are open not only for investors who have a little bit more privileged regime than traders, but for any ways of businesses, and would be happy to see much more active engagement with US businesses on any ways of business, provided they know what to do in Uzbekistan, how to sell, and if they do not know, we would be standing ready to help them. At the end of the day, we are talking not about 32 million country, but we are talking about the region. And it is fantastic region, the region in the growth and creating tremendous opportunities. For the first time, we introduced the Ombudsman on business ombudsman. And this is also important because we understand that middle and small and medium-sized businesses is a backbone of economy. We see process of re-engagement with the international financial institutions which cease the activities in Uzbekistan. A particular European Bank for Reconstruction and Development. They're opening fully fledged office in Uzbekistan. We are starting operations with them somewhere in November. We are signing around $200 million of credit line for small and medium-sized businesses and a number of projects, again, in private sector and municipal projects as well. 2 days ago here in Washington, we signed an agreement with the European Investment Bank. They're also starting their operations in Uzbekistan, and this is the largest investment bank in the world, and they're quite eager to have their presence in Uzbekistan. Historically, we have very good relations with Asian Development Bank. We're one of the founding members of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. So there are many opportunities for businesses to work with us through those well-known financial institutions. Those who are interested in doing business in Uzbekistan, we would welcome them to go individually within the trade mission, which is going to be organized by American Uzbek Chamber of Commerce, or we will have a large investment forum in Tashkent in 2018. Mr. Kudratov, who is a member of our delegation, will be happy to share his information on this. If we talk about the foreign policy of Uzbekistan, which dramatically changed from, I would say, a sedimentary style to very proactive style. And this year alone, we witnessed 16 presidential level visits, more than 15 meetings on a high level, and we signed around 230 different commercial agreements, totaling $43 billion worth of investment into Uzbekistan. So Windows, of course, 43 billions, 2.6 billions of US investment, which were a result of the very successful business forum which took place last month in New York, and we look forward for a much larger and much active engagement with the United States of America. The cornerstone of our foreign policy is our regional engagement. And those who have been observing the region of Central Asia has witnessed many, many contacts on the presidential level, because the key slogan for our regional cooperation is Central Asia is our main priority. I mean, one of the breakthroughs is our border agreement, which we signed with Kyrgyzstan. We had the last 25 years unresolved border issue. For the moment, we are very proud that in 1 year, we have formalized 85% of our borderline, and was ratified by parliaments of both countries, and that all legal procedures have been fulfilled by two presidents of the states. And remaining 15%, we hope to finalize by the end of the 2018. So we virtually resolved the major issues and major obstacles and handicaps that does not help Uzbekistan to engage regionally. We conducted a number of regional trade missions, exchanges, cultural events. So next year, Kazakhstan will be contacting you of Uzbekistan. We have same arrangement with Tajikistan, with Kyrgyzstan, Turkmenistan. So all things are happening and they're bearing fruits, and our trade turnover with each of our neighbor has increased dramatically, at least 30% for the last 9 months, which gives, there is a very strong dynamism happening in the year, but there is also building of mutual trust and understanding between all the walks of societies as well as on presidential levels as well. When we talk about Central Asia, the issue of security is of course on agenda. Next November, and I believe Professor Stai is going to attend the regional conference on security, then all leaders of Central Asia and all representatives will be discussing what we can do to make Central Asia more safe, more secure. But when we talk about security, it is more Afghanistan, which of course concerns us. And we boosted our engagement with Afghanistan. We expect by end of this year visit of President Ghani. We had a number of, again, meetings, presidential level meetings during on the platform of international events. And we would be quite eager to help Afghanistan, of course, more economically, to be part of many economic projects which take part in this country. We introduced Institute of the Special Ambassador on Afghanistan, and he is working very actively and participating in all events relating to Afghanistan. So hopefully Afghanistan will remain on our radar and we will be able to help this country to move forward. United States is very important for Uzbekistan. We are proud to have very good relations with all our neighbors, but unless US and Uzbekistan, one cannot feel the sense of wholeness. The more international stakeholders increase their activities in Uzbekistan, is better for us. We understand perfectly well that we are a medium-sized country and we need to maintain our relationship with each and everybody. This is one of the beacons of democracy. We want to be a European-style democracy, and of course we need to have good relations with Europe. We understand that we need to compete with China, we need to compete with Russia. We position ourselves as an industrial hub for Central Asia. That means we need high technologies. And high technologies comes from Europe, from US, and that means we need close engagement. We definitely need larger pool of investors. We definitely need to increase our turnover. We definitely need to boost our financial sector, services, and others. And we can't do this unless we have a very strong partners, and those partners are coming from the US. We are very glad that we have very positive dialogue with the US government. We seen a very positive letter from the President Trump sent to the President of Uzbekistan during his visit to New York. We hope that that trend and tendency will continue, but at the same time we are open, and I had great discussions with a number of you who wants to engage with Uzbekistan, and we are happy to be part of this process. We need, as I told you, much stronger cooperation, and I hope that relationship will expand to parliamentary links as well, because I do represent Senate of Uzbekistan, and for a young democracy as Uzbekistan, to strengthen the parliamentarism, you have to work with American partners. I'm glad that in November we'll have a small team of six parliamentarians, including myself, who are part of the Open World program, and that will help our very young, very dynamic parliamentarians to immerse into how the parliamentarism is conducted in the US. I hope we will have much more such exchange programs, not only on parliament, on trade, on education, people-to-people democratic processes. Or we would be very glad to see Friendship Society, US, Uzbekistan, because I believe many of you love this country and many people would love to do something. So we are very open and we would love to see you in Uzbekistan, we would welcome you. And again, thank you very much for your time, for your attention, and hope to see you soon either here or there. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Chairman and Senator Klimanov.